the letter of St. James. Be patient until the coming of the Lord. See how the farmers wait for the precious fruit of the earth, being patient with it until it receives the first early and late rain. You too must be patient. Make your hearts firm, because the coming of the Lord is at hand. Do not complain, brothers and sisters, about one another, that you may not be judged. Behold, the judge is standing before the gate. Take an example of the hardship of patience, brothers and sisters, the prophets who spoke in the name of God. The word of God.
Thank you, God.
St. James, in this one of his letters, there are two letters that he wrote, writing to the people of Jerusalem, from where he was bishop, is reminding them of what really it is the most important part of our Christian calling, to wait for the coming of Christ, to wait for him at his parousia, to wait for him at his second coming. My dear, as we are preparing during this focus for this joyful season to commemorate the birth of Christ, the true preparation of the church is for his second coming. When he comes to give us what we hope for and to take us home with him, we who trust in him. The farmer, when he goes to sow, as scripture said it in one of the Psalms, he goes with tears, because he's going to put his crop into the ground, but there is no security that he is going to have the fruit of his crop, either because he is going to die before the harvest, or because the weather is not going to cooperate.
This is the joy of us, that
We know that he will come again because his word is not something that we take it lightly. I am going to prepare a place for you and I will come back. And he will come back to take us home, we who have accepted him. We who have walked to walk with him. We who have trusted him and hoped him. But mostly it's because his same compassion and healing he has bestowed on us is now the healing and compassion he is expecting us to request. And while we administer to others this compassion of Christ, we will be joyful. We will experience joy. We will be giving consolation. Because although we are ministering to others, in the meantime, we too endure that joy, that consolation that our ministry brings. Because God not only asks us to give, but he also blesses and rewards with great gladness and joy the heart of those who give. It is more pleasure to give, Saint Paul said, than to receive. As we go to celebration of the Eucharist tonight, as we advance very properly, and tomorrow we begin this, the very novena of Christmas, 9 days before Christmas, which I really appeal to you for Masses these 9 days. This is the proper part of heaven, where the Church focuses totally and completely on those beautiful episodes and also scripture passages and antiphons which identify who Christ is, the Son of the living God, who come for one purpose, to bring his salvation. May these 9 days, as we begin tomorrow from the 17th to the 24th, inspire each one of us not to be assumed or